It's coronavirus time, which means everyone's locked indoors. Sick and tired of quarantine, you decide to go where you can't possibly infect or be infected by the virus. Nature. Except maybe all this time indoors had made you forget one crucial fact. Nature sucks and really wants to kill you. Don't worry, Infographics is here to remind you of all the reasons man invented apartment buildings and Netflix, with some of the most venomous bites and stings in the world. Warning. Some of these entries contain images that may be difficult to stomach. Black widow spider. Scarlett Johansson notwithstanding, black widow bites are pretty terrible affairs. These spiders can be identified by the red hourglass-like coloring on the abdomen set against the black body, and they inhabit every continent on Earth, except Antarctica. With venom as much as 15 times as potent as a rattlesnake, these tiny eight-legged horrors can cause anything from moderate discomfort to death, depending on how sensitive the person is to the venom. Luckily, they discharge far less venom than a rattlesnake per bite, or else they'd surely be exponentially more deadly. So what delights are in store for you after getting a love bite from everyone's second favorite black widow? Within 15 minutes, you'll start feeling cramps in the area where you were bitten, as your nervous system fires off random signals uncontrollably. Within the first hour, your body will begin to experience powerful muscle spasms as the venom goes all 2007 Britney Spears on your neurotransmitters. Now the pain begins to become acute, and good news for all you wannabe heartthrobs, because your abdomen will become rock hard as the muscles cramp. The venom isn't trying to give you a sweet beach bod, though. Instead, the alpha-latrotoxin and accompanying cocktails of chemicals is busy trying to kill as many of your nerve endings as possible. Remember, this is a spider that kills by paralyzing its prey. Lucky for most of you, you're too big for the venom to completely shut down your nervous system. Unluckily for you, things are still going to be very, very painful. After about 3 hours, your cramps will become acute, leading to extreme pain. You may be looking for painkillers at this point, but because of the effect of narcotics on the body, doctors likely won't prescribe them for fear of helping the venom shut down your breathing. Your skin will get clammy and your blood pressure drop, which will lead to mild delirium and mental confusion. Pregnant women will likely go into labor at this point. As you move into day 2 of your ordeal, and assuming you haven't died yet, symptoms will start to fade, though you can look forward to large amounts of swelling in the affected area for several more days. Black widows may be painful, but they don't even hold a candle to our next entry on this list, Irukanji jellyfish. Jellyfish are simple creatures. They have almost no measurable intelligence, and their entire hunting strategy consists of floating around aimlessly. Irukanji takes everything that's awful about jellyfish and cranks it up to 11. Jellyfish are notoriously difficult to see and avoid already, and the Irukanji doubled down on that and became even smaller and more difficult to see. The bell is only about 5 to 25 millimeters wide, but the tentacles can extend up to a meter in length. While other jellyfish have only stingers on the tentacles, Irukanji was kind enough to line even its bell with stingers. You know, so there's absolutely no chance of avoiding getting stung if you run into one. Despite its tiny size, Irukanji jellyfish pack one of the biggest venomous wallops in the world, and is generally accepted as being the most painful sting in Mother Nature. The initial sting is only mildly painful, and leads most swimmers to believe they ran into a common jellyfish. However, within minutes, as the venom circulates through the body, the real nightmare begins. Painful muscle cramps first hit the arms and legs, which can lead to drowning. As the venom makes its way into the organs, the kidneys pulsate with pain akin to that of a kidney stone, while the back begins to spasm. Waves of fiery pain course through the body as nausea, headaches, uncontrolled sweating, and vomiting kick in. The heart begins to race uncontrollably, leading to serious problems for those with pre-existing heart conditions. Hospitalization is absolutely necessary for an Irukanji sting, and even the most powerful narcotic painkillers have been widely reported to be completely ineffective. Victims must simply ride out the pain as hospitals try and make them as comfortable as possible. Perhaps the most terrifying part, though, is the way the venom causes psychological feelings of doom and despair, leading to suicidal thoughts and depression. At least the Irukanji jellyfish have the decency of trying to kill you. Our next entry will leave holes in your body if it gets its fangs inside you. Brown recluse. Warning, this next entry contains some disturbing images. Spiders are basically the jellyfish of land. They're often extremely venomous, difficult to see, and there's probably one working its way up your pant leg right now, but you probably think we're kidding and you just feel a random tickle. If it's a brown recluse on your leg, though, you better start making arrangements to get to the hospital. A bite from a brown recluse is typically painless, though you'll start to feel tender around the bitten area within a few hours. The area will become inflamed quickly, with burning pain setting in. If you're lucky, this is as bad as it'll get. But most people are not lucky when it comes to brown recluse spiders. For the unlucky victims, necrosis will set in around the affected area as the venom destroys the surrounding tissues. Typically, this begins with a very large blister then an ulcer will start to develop. Over the course of 1 or 2 weeks, the ulcer grows by inches, and dead tissue begins to blacken and scab on the wound. Within 3 weeks, the bite will finally begin to heal, but can take up to 3 months to fully heal. Depending on the location you were bitten, you may need skin grafts or full-on reconstructive surgery to recover from the massive tissue death, and you'll likely carry a significant scar or deformity for the rest of your life. Some victims may even need a limb amputation. Brown recluses only sting defensively, but our next entry doesn't just pack one of the most painful stings in the world. It can fly and chase down its victims. Tarantula hawk. No, it's not a spider that can fly like a hawk. Even that's too terrifying for nature to come up with. Instead, the tarantula hawk is a species of wasp that lives to prey on spiders. If you live in the southern United States or South and Central America, you're smack dab in this species' habitat. Tarantula hawks like to hunt down spiders and inject them with venom that paralyzes them. The wasp then drags the spider into a hole and plants its eggs inside of it. The growing young promptly hatches and feeds on the still-living spider, kind of like a really slow-acting xenomorph. In humans, the venom isn't strong enough to paralyze, but it's more than enough to create one of the most painful experiences of your life. American entomologist Justin Schmidt, who has dedicated his life to creation of the Schmidt Sting Pain Index, has this to say about the tarantula hawk sting. All you can do is lay down and scream. The good news is that the pain only lasts about 5 minutes. The bad news is that this will definitely be the most painful 5 minutes of your life, other than that last time you tried to do something special in the bedroom for your significant other, only to be a complete disappointment. And that is an infographic sting, with pain that can last from minutes to a lifetime. Our next entry is not only so well camouflaged that many people get stung by accident each year, but the pain of even a glancing sting can last for years. Stonefish. Its camouflage is almost perfect, and 13 deadly spines line its body to ward off would-be predators. Unfortunately for humans, these same spines routinely end up piercing the bottom of swimmers' feet fairly regularly. For its victims, there's few experiences in life more painful than getting stung by a stonefish. One swimmer stung by a stonefish in Australia managed to accidentally nick one with a finger, and that was more than enough to bring on a nightmare of pain that would last years. Stung on the finger, the pain was immediate and intense, described as having a sledgehammer smash into each knuckle, the wrist, the elbow, and then up to the shoulder for an entire hour after the sting. After that, the venom went to work on the kidneys, causing so much pain the victim couldn't stand or sit straight up, and was forced to remain doubled over in crippling agony. For him, as with most victims, the pain would take years to go away, with recurring kidney pain striking long after the initial sting. And that was just a glancing blow on a single spine. Divers who have stepped onto a stonefish and experienced several of the spines piercing their body have experienced pain so intense they begged for their limbs to be amputated. Now that's just one more reason to leave the ocean to the jellyfish, in our opinion. Now go watch Scientists Finally Know Why Mosquitoes Bite Some People More Than Others, or click this other video instead.